the first time into their native language, in their heart language, they are receiving the Bible. And this is how we do that. And this ministry is still with us in Nagaland, and I am Asa.
I'm here in Panama.
Yeah, I'm here in Panama, and I am Asa, facilitator for all those translators who comes in. And we are grateful to all those donors who could be able to help us thus far. And our children, our staff, and especially my wife and all of those women folks, they greet you all in the name of the Lord. And they told me several times that you go there, since we could not go there and meet her, you just go there and hug her. So I just want to hug her, because this is the hug from all of our children, all of our staff, and all of our ministry who are there, and all of our pastors who are there.
So that,
so well, this
Mom,
is what I'm here.
Mom, you don't have to. When you think of Van Palm, what do you think about? What comes to mind?
Oh, my. It would be hard for me to explain, because we just treated him as part of our family, really. We just loved him like he was part of our family. And he's done such a tremendous work. I'm so proud of him. So proud of him. He and his wife.
And, Mom, take a moment, because Mom helped you educate children. She helped you feed children.
Yes.
Take a moment and tell us maybe some of those children who graduated from school.
Oh, yes.
What kind of people are they?
Okay, I will tell you. Those children in the beginning who were helped and grown up and then educated, now, some of them are, you know, they got married, settled down their lives, and some of them graduated, get a very good job, you know. And those children, when they meet us on the road or anywhere else, they will just bow down to us, saying, because of you that we are here, we could be able to achieve something. So they get a... They are in a good jobs. Many of our children, they are there.
What and kind of jobs?
They work